near to you in the quiet of this day. Never a sin, a lost and forsaken. Never a sin, a blind and a lame. Call to us now, and we shall awaken. We shall arise at the sound of our name. We are the young, our lives are a mystery. We are the old who yearn for your face. We have been sung throughout all of history, called to be light to the whole human race. Gather a sin, the rich and the haughty. Gather a sin, the proud and the strong. Give us a heart so weak and so lonely. Give us the courage to enter the song.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and the peace and the fellowship of the Lord Jesus Christ be with you all. Together this wonderful sunny cold morning to reflect on our life and where it goes. Let's take a moment to call God's mercy.
Lord Jesus, before you left this earth, you promised your followers that you would return in glory at the second coming. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you challenge us to have our spiritual houses in order, prepared for the end of our time on earth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, help us to remain in vigilance and preparedness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to life everlasting.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the most high.
sins in mind and body alike, and pursue and freedom them apart. The things that are yours, through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Book of Wisdom. Resplendent and unfading is wisdom, and she is readily perceived by those who love her, and found by those who seek her. She hastens to make herself known in anticipation of their desire. Whoever watches for her at dawn shall not be disappointed, for he shall find her sitting by his gate. For taking thought of wisdom is the perfection of prudence, and whoever, for her sake, keeps vigil shall quickly be free from care, because she makes her own rounds, seeking those worthy of her, and graciously appears to them in the ways, and meets them with all solitude. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
On the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Of ancient Israel, we nonetheless are very familiar with this Lord's message, that is, being vigilant, being prepared. Each year at this time, we are asked to reflect on how ready and prepared we are for the second coming, and should it come soon, and how ready we are for our own deaths. I would bet that most of us don't spend too much time thinking about the second coming. Conversely, I assume we do think, at least occasionally, about our own death, especially those of us who are older. Being prepared and vigilant, of course, is code for being sinless, or having our spiritual lives in order so that we will be candidates for heaven the day we die. And this challenge from Jesus is to have our houses in order is not just an occasional suggestion that he made, like today in this gospel. You will recall another parable that he taught on this subject. It was the one about the farmer, the very rich farmer, and it's found in Luke's gospel, chapter 12, verse 16. Jesus tells the story about this farmer who had a bountiful harvest that particular year. And he asked himself, what should I do since I do not have space to store my harvest? So he decided that I'll tear down my barns and rebuild new ones, larger ones, so he'd have plenty of storage for many years to come. And then he said he'd rest, eat, drink, and be merry. But God said to him, you fool, this night your life will be demanded of you. And the things you have prepared, to whom will they belong? To whom will they belong? Jesus concludes this parable by saying, quote, thus will it be for the one who store up treasure for himself, but is not rich in what matters for God. But is not rich in what matters for God. So back to the convergence. Again, Jesus teaches in picture stories that were, in the context, familiar to the people of his day. The parable about the five wise and the five foolish virgins is set in the Palestinian marriage custom practice of that time. At that time, when a man and woman were married, they were first betrothed. There were various stages in the course of getting married. Technically, once betrothed, they were considered married, and yet they didn't live together for probably another year. And during this year, as the families settled financial matters between the two of them, once that was done, then the bridegroom would get up, go through a very public procession to meet his bride. The whole town generally knew about it, and they would come out of their houses and greet them, the groom's entourage, and cheer him on. Only then did the wedding feast festival begin, usually at the home where the new couple, the newlyweds, would live. And the wedding would go on for many days. You think our weddings are complicated these days. So most likely the virgins of Christ's parable were seen as part of the bridal party, waiting for the arrival of the groom. And there are several features in this story that are connected to Jesus' intent of asking us to be prepared for the hereafter. It was traditional to read in ancient Jewish writings that a wedding feast or a banquet were seen as symbols of the final fulfillment of heaven as we have come to think about it. Then there is this issue about waiting in the dark, right? Never really knowing when it will come. In the parable, we hear that for some reason that the bridegroom was delayed, so the virgins fell asleep. But at midnight came the warning that the procession was coming, so the virgins awoke and trimmed their lamps, probably dipping these torches that they were probably having rather than lanterns into these pots of oil to replenish the flame so they could light it up again. Scripture scholars suggest that this story is not about falling asleep, since all 10 of them fell asleep. And it's really not about generosity, meaning that the virgins, the the extra oil were not being stingy, but they were being wise. For if they had shared their oil, then probably everyone would have run out, and everyone would have been in the dark. Rather, the lesson is about preparedness, about vigilance, about mindfulness, anticipation, about thinking ahead, about being ready for whatever will come, about being wise on how one is living one's life. And speaking about wisdom, we noticed that our liturgy of the word started off talking about wisdom. The first reading is from a very short section of the book of wisdom from the Hebrew scriptures. All cultures have, in some way, whether through stories or writings or cultural practices, a way to honor and uphold the wisdom of their ancestors or their elders. And it was no different in ancient Israel. And this was captured in this book of wisdom, written about 100 years before Christ, and it's centered around insights or learnings, lessons gleaned from life experiences, so that they were meant to be kind of moral guides or moral compasses to its readers. And this section, briefly, portrays the wisdom in the persona of a woman who is resplendent, meaning brilliant, shining bright, radiant, and who is also unfading. She is the object of one's desire and attention, yet to find her, this wisdom, one must be vigilant. Whoever watches for her at dawn shall not be disappointed, for he shall find her sitting at the gate. And whoever for her sake keeps vigil shall quickly be free from care. So wisdom is a gift to be sought, yet only found if we are vigilant and watchful, translate attention. And if we are fortunate to find it, we hear that we shall quickly be free from care. So connecting this back to our gospel parable, St. Thomas Aquinas described wisdom as the habit of looking at everything in the light of our last end, looking at everything in the light of our last day. In other words, the wise person is the one who assesses everything, every choice, every decision, every crossroad in life, in the light of our final union with God in heaven. So as usual, there are many things that we could reflect on from these readings today. They certainly challenge us to listen to the holder of wisdom in our lives, whether they are our elders, whether living in, or whether we hold their memories in our hearts. The readings challenge us to live in the present, to live in preparedness, mindful that our presence could end at any moment. And with this in mind, I know that several of you have suffered this tragic and sudden loss of a loved one in your life. You have lived this parable of seeing how important it is to be vigilant, to be prepared for the unexpected. Gail and I have lost all four of our parents, but we were blessed, as each of them died, to have enough time to say what we needed to say to them and to say goodbye. I know this is not true for many of you, when you experience such loss. And the stories of tragic loss and sudden death are all around us every day, aren't they? The stories of healthy and friends and neighbors who die suddenly or tragically. Countless stories of traffic accidents and drug overdoses in our area and state. Say nothing about the endless accounts of gun violence, gun violent death, like this awful one that happened recently at this small church in Texas. Or the endless tragedies that happen from natural disasters that we hear and read about in our world every day. Our lives, whether very personally or from more of a distance, are full of examples of why we need to be living our lives today in the present as if there may be no tomorrow. So whether we indeed are reflecting on the great second coming or more personally reflecting on our own final going, today's lesson is at least about being prepared, about being vigilant. And besides having our wills made out and recorded and our living wills for the end of life medical decision that others might be making for us, made out and filed, this vigilance also, most especially, must include spiritual preparedness. And like the foolish virgins who quickly knew that they were vulnerable and unprepared, most of us know if we are spiritually unprepared should that day of reckoning come today. Most of us know where we come up short, right? Where we are conflicted or where we are compromising and how we act and behave compared to the person we know that Jesus is calling us to be. Today's gospel has Jesus summarizing this challenge by saying, quote, therefore stay awake. You know neither the day nor the hour. So our prayer, may our prayer be that we work harder to keep our oil jars full and ready for everything, especially our last days. May we pray for the wisdom and the guidance of the Holy Spirit to strengthen our resolve to keep our own spiritual houses in order. May we have vigilant hearts, prepared to take our place in this great wedding feast that we hear about in the gospel, because we have stored up riches in what matters for God. We have stored up riches in what matters.
Presence of the Lord, and for those who mourn them in this life, we pray.
morning, we're especially remembering our beloved Father Michael DeMassey and other deceased members of the Knights of Columbus 307 for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
So spirits to you, O Lord, be not far, we pray, listen to these our prayers, granting them according to your will, through Jesus Christ, your Son, who is our Lord forever and ever.
Amen.
There is a second collection day today for our field.
Offertory song is on page 2 of the gospel folder, Because He Lives. God sent His Son. They called Him Jesus. He came to love. He the Lamb for Him. He lived and died. To buy my pardon and empty grave. There to prove my Savior lives, because He lives, I can face tomorrow, because He lives, all fear is gone.
Fear is gone.
pray, O Lord, upon the gifts offered here, and celebrating in mystery the passion of your Son, we may honor it with loving devotion to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Lord.
Let us now give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from an ending death. By rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. So with all the angels and archangels, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Thank you.
sins as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever, always.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Be still and know I am here.
Because I am right, I will be your guide. Come and rest in me. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by your name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine. I'm strength for all the despairing. Healing for the ones who dwell in shame. All the blind will see, one thing will be free, and all will know my name. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by the name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine. Bye-bye. I am the one that leads all to freedom. The peace the world cannot give. I will call your name, embracing all your pain. Stand up now, walk and live. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me, I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine. I love you and you are mine.
Welcome them back. So, Inland Sea. who had their picture taken, put the picture directly, but did not order pictures, there's, their 8x10 is available back in the hallway, so please pick that up. And the Diocese of Burlington is having a synod, the first since the 1960s. This will be an opportunity to discuss concerns of our diocese. Next week, Bishop Coy will speak at all the masses via video to introduce the process. For more details, check out next week's bulletin along with our parish and diocesan website for further details. It's a good video. Actually, you'll see next week this on our parish website about the upcoming diocesan synod. And just a reminder, thank you for the servers. Anything you want to say? Thank our choir, our music men here to help us sing. Deacon and David for his homily. And we have any veterans out there? Any of us? Any veterans? Okay, thank you very much. I was there. How many Air Force? Any Air Force? There's two, one, two, three. Thank you very much. That's me. My niece is still in the Air Force. All right, please join us now in the parish hall after this Mass for coffee and donuts and fellowship. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
And the blessing of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon us this day.
Amen. With celebrations ended, we now take our preparedness out into the world to love and serve the Lord and one another.
Amen. Closing songs on page 2 in the Gospel folder, in the Sweet By and By.
There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there, in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that dear little shore, in the sweet by and by. We shall meet on that beautiful shore. We shall sing on that beautiful shore the melodious songs of the blessed, and our spirit shall sorrow no more. Not a sigh for the blessing of rest in the sweet by and by. We shall be on that beautiful shore, in the sweet by and by. We shall be on that beautiful shore.